It has been almost around 1 year that everyone is talking about the AI tools since the generative AI become a very popular thing. And there are tons of different design tools out there that are using the same technology and we can use for different purposes, such as generating images or videos or even user interface. And in this video, I'm going to give a try to some of these design tools and I'm going to share my experience using these tools to build a website from scratch. And if you want to know how the result is going to be, get sure to watch this video until then. My name is Kia and here is Kimo. Welcome to my channel. I'm going to be honest with you. So far, I could not use any AI tools in my design process. The reason that I cannot really use the AI and utilize them in my working process is that I could not find a reliable design tool that using this technology. Maybe if I can get satisfied with the result that this AI tools are generating, then I can really rely on them. However, I believe it's time for me to give another chance to these design tools and use them in my design process and see if I can really rely on them or not. Before we go further in this video, I would like to ask you to subscribe to my channel, like this video, and share it with the other designers in your community. And at the end, of course, don't forget to share your opinion and thoughts regarding this video and in general about any other video in my channel in the comment section. These are the ways that you can support me and help me to build a more relevant and higher quality content regarding the UX and UI and design in general in this channel. The case study that I'm going to work on it in this video is basically the landing page of a very simple portfolio website. I'm going to use Rerlume in order to generate the wireframe for my webpage. And then I'm going to use the Galileo to transform the wireframes that I have to final UI. And after that, I'm going to import the result to Figma and use the Figma to Framer plugin in order to import the UI that we have into Framer. And at the end, I'm going to publish it. So this is the general process that I'm going to go through it. Okay, this is the Relume environment, working environment, basically. And I have already logged in this platform. So you see basically the dashboard or the homepage of my working environment. I can make new project by clicking here on this button on top next to my profile avatar. We can say just to start a building. And then we will be landed in our design file. Here you can see that we have a two tab on top. The first one is sitemap. Here is basically the section that we can work on the sitemap of our website. So how many pages we would like to have, how is the structure of our sitemap, the information architecture, and the rest of the stuff. And here in the other tab, we can work basically on our design, basically wireframe, the detail of the pages, different pages that we have in our sitemap. Okay, right now I see in the sitemap section that I have already one homepage here. I can of course write down more description here and generate the rest of the sitemap, including the rest of the detail page and intermediate pages. However, in my case, I don't need to do that. Just to show you how it works, I can give a try here. So describe the company in the section. Okay, this is basically a very simple description that I give to this AI tool, and let's see which kind of sitemap it's going to generate for us. You can of course define the number of pages that you would like to have in your website and the language. Okay, you can see that we have already a very complex sitemap. So the Rerlume is generating the landing page, including all the kind of component and sections that we might need in our landing page. And you can also see the rest of the pages that we might need, of course, for our website, including the About Us, Services, Portfolio, the projects, Contact Us, and the rest. It's a very impressive thing. However, we of course need to always monitor the result and customizes based on our knowledge. So let's switch to the wireframe section first. The page structure is very easy. We have this hero section on top with the image and headline and the rest of the stuff. We have this section down here and the rest of the section, such as this kind of teaser section and testimonial rating, blah, blah, the rest. It's a pretty long page. One good thing about Rerlume is that we can have full control on every section to customize it in a way that we believe it might have a better impact on our end users. Of course, we can change the prompt that we give to the tool and give another try and see how we can customize our prompt to get a better result. The other thing that we can do is that we can select each individual section, and here in the menu, we can basically just work on that specific section and kind of customize it in a way that we want. For example, I select this hero section, and I can say, okay, I would like to have a video here instead of the image, and I can add the different stuff here. We can even replace it with different components. If I click on here and replace with a component, you can see that we can switch between different hero section that Rerlume has in its own library, which is very nice kind of feature. The other cool feature that will help us to customize the kind of component that we have in our wireframe is the way that we can kind of customize the copywriting that we have. So we can select each text in our wireframe and then ask AI to kind of write down the text that we believe is better for us. Well, you can just prompt here, write down any prompt that you would like to describe the way that you would like to kind of describe your own company here in the hero section, and the AI is going to generate you some sort of copyright. Now I just need to export this result to somewhere that I can use as a reference for the next AI tool that I'm going to use for generating my user interface. However, for that purpose, I have to kind of upgrade to starter license package. As you can see that if I click here on the, on the export, I have these options such as export to Figma or export to Webflow, or the other things that I can use for copywriting. However, when I click on, for example, export to Figma, you can see that I get this error that I cannot go further with the free version that I have. And in this video, I just want to give a try. I don't want to upgrade to next level of the license. However, I could, but yeah, let's continue with the free version. What I'm going to do is I'm going to just make a screenshot from this result, and then feed the next AI tool with the screenshot that I have. I made the screenshots of the sections that I would like to have in my final design, and I brought them in a Figma, and I kind of organized them in this way. I didn't bring everything that was in the initial wireframe that has been done by the Rerlume, and I just wanted to keep simple, so there is no other reason. And of course, it would be better if I had the upgraded version in order to import and export the whole wireframe in an easier way. But let's give a try and continue this way and see how it will work. So this is going to be the reference of my user interface. I'm going to export this one more time in a PNG in order to be able to give it to the next AI tool. Okay, Galileo is the AI tool that I'm going to use in order to generate my final UI. It's a very amazing tool. I never use it actually in detail, but the thing that I'm seeing here, and of course, if you switch to explore, into the text to UI, and here there are some examples that when I check them, I feel like this is a tool that I really need in order to generate the user interface with minimum effort and using the generative AI. For example, let's check this one. You can see the prompt, which is basically an example, but of course, if we use a similar structure in our prompt, we might get the same result. Here in the example, the prompt is like this: a profile page for a Japanese inspired store for cool ceramics that feature the history of makery and ceramics for sale. Make the color light orange. And the Galileo bot is giving this result here. The cool thing about this tool is that we can copy paste the result by clicking on here directly to the Figma. So I click here and this Figma button, and then I switch back to the Figma that I have and use the combination key control V to bring the design into my Figma. And the most amazing thing about this is that the copy version of the design that Galileo generated is, of course, open layered. So basically, you have access to all layers that we might need in our design process, the text layers, image, and blah, 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 and the rest. And you can see that it's already using the auto layout. So it's a very cool, ready to use kind of design layout. And this is very fascinating. I found it very interesting, very nice. Okay, let's get back to the Galileo here. And I see one feature here, image to UI. And I assume here I can give a reference of the thing that I would like to have. I'm not very sure. Let's switch it to the web version because the wireframe that I have is for the web. And I'm going to upload my reference here. Okay, the wireframe that we made is already uploaded here. And I can, of course, write down some prompt here in order to clarify the detail of the design, the UI that I would like to have at the end. We can say I would like to have a minimal UI, flat, modern, and maybe you can add other adjective here. We are doing it for just educational purpose, so I will just keep it simple. Here in the next step, we can decide the color theme of our design or the more detail regarding our design. For example, we can design or have the dark version or dark theme for our UI, or we can have some other color kind of thing. And we can even define the corner radius of our element. For example, I would like to have sharper edges for my stuff, or I would like to have kind of rounded edges for my element in the scene. Let's generate the first prompt that we mentioned, the first version, and see how the result is going to be based on the wireframe that we gave. Okay, here we are. We have the result of our first prompt. And as you can see, some of the part of this thing is matching one with one with the thing that we had in our wireframe, such as in navigation. Not one with one, it's my bad, but generally it's very close to what we had in our wireframe. Let me just make a copy of this design and take it to my Figma file and compare it with the wireframe. Okay, this is it. So the design is next to wireframe. This is what Galileo generated, and this is what Rerlume generated for me. The first hero section is not exactly what we had in the Rerlume. Of course, the main UI element that we see on each section is fairly similar to what we had in wireframe. Like we have a hero, headline in the hero section in our design, which we can find it also here. We have the paragraph text. Here we have it as well. The buttons are here as well. And the layout that we have for a hero section is very different than what we have here. Not that big difference. I can maybe adjust it myself very quickly. Adjusted the hero section in, to have more similar layout to wireframe that we had. But one of the things that kind of grabbing my attention right now is the similarity between the copywriting that we have in our final design and compared to what we have in the wireframe. Galileo did a very good job in order to pick up the text from our wireframe and having it here in the final design. You can see that the headline is exactly the same. The text, paragraph text, is also same. And the next section also is basically using the same text that we had in our wireframe, which is very amazing, very impressive. Okay, so I am done in this step. Let's take our design to the framer and publish our final website and see how the result is going to be. For exporting our design into the framer, I'm going to use the plugin that is officially from the framer itself. So I'm going to open up the plugin section, plugin center, and search for Figma to Framer plugin. And this one is the one that we need, Figma to HTML with Framer. So I'm going to run the plugin And then here it says that select the layer to copy. I'm just gonna select this layer. And I'm gonna run the plugin one more time. And you can see that it's copying already everything that we had in this layer. And when it's ready, it's come, this menu appears here, or this window is appearing here, that we can click on the copy to clipboard. And in this way, we kind of have the design ready to take it to the framer. Then I'm gonna come to the framer in the page that we kind of have here. And I'm going to use the combination key Control V to duplicate all the design that we had in the Figma. Okay, the design is here, you can see already. I'm going to position it into my viewport into our kind of frame that we have, the mainframe. We can, of course, publish our design into our custom domain or in the general domain that we have here for test. Now I can open the test that we have, the design, and you can see that everything is already there. And it's ready to actually be used. So the overall process is very nice, very intuitive. However, it's still about the result. I would say it has potential and room for improvement. And of course, we from outside, we could also work a little bit more on the prompt and adjustment of our prompt in order to get a better result. But all in all, I would say I'm very happy about the process and the result that we have. Is we have been working on this thing for around maybe 40 minutes, including the recording time. So things are very fast and I like it very much. What I didn't like about these tools that I use today are this point. The first thing about Rerlume was that Rerlume to me is basically a design library, including all the section and components. And basically is trying to kind of match the component that we might need based on our prompt. So it doesn't have so much flexibility. However, it has enough components there in their component list that we can build up our website and customize them later on in the Figma when we are working on their UI. And the other thing that I feel like it would be great to have is that right now in the Rerlume, we can work on our wireframe and on our sitemap and information architecture and copywriting, but the next step is missing. The next step is basically building the UI based on the wireframe that we have, which I saw in the website of Rerlume that they are working on such a feature, and the next step, bring this feature into the Rerlume as well. That would be a very amazing experience to build a website by just prompting, getting the wireframe, confirming them, and then generating the user interface. About the Galileo, I have to say that I'm very impressed by the way that it kind of detect the text of my wireframe, the text that I had in the wireframe, and generating the UI based on those texts and using those copywriting in my final UI. However, I still can kind of argue about the quality of the decision that the AI made for the user interface that it generate. Including the decision regarding the distances, the spacing and grids, the colors, and some other detail about the UI design, which we can, of course, customize it later on. And the cool feature about the Galileo was that we can copy the results directly into Figma and then work further on this kind of design, so we don't have to start from scratch when we go to the Figma. Please let me know which kind of AI design tools you are using in your design process, and if you are happy with them, or you believe also they need to improve the quality and accuracy of the models that are generating this design, especially when it comes to user interface design. And get sure to share the name of those design tools with me in the comment section. And that was it for this video. I hope you enjoyed this video and learned something new. And if it was so, please don't forget to like this video, share it with the other designers in your community, and subscribe to my channel if you're new here and if you haven't done it yet. And share your thoughts and opinion in the comment section with me. I'm gonna read them. I'm trying to respond to all of them. And if you have any question, and if you need help in your design process, reach out to me. Let's learn together and see you in the next video.